Hi, I'm David Peggie. I'm a chemist in the scientific department here at the National Gallery in London. In this series, we're going to be talking about the various pigments used in the paintings in our collection. Today, we're going to be talking about malachite. So let's look at this painting, Giovanni Bellini's Agony in the Garden. Painted in 1458-60, this is the earliest work of Bellini's we have in our collection, and it's painted in egg tempera on a poplar panel. Giovanni Bellini was a Venetian painter, born into the leading dynasty of Venetian painters with a career that spanned six decades. He is one of the most influential artists of all time. In the landscape, and perhaps surprisingly, in the discarded cloak of St. James, Bellini has used malachite. While painters would have known that the pigment was a green-coloured copper mineral, they would not have known its precise chemical identity. However, having analysed this type of green pigment in many different paintings, we know that a specific mineral, malachite, was the most commonly encountered. Italian artists may have known this pigment as Verdetto della Magna, meaning green from Germany, perhaps hinting at its possible origin. The source of the pigment Bellini used is difficult to confirm, but there is evidence to suggest that in this period, it may have come from the historic copper mines in the Carpathian Mountains in present-day Slovakia. Usually, to obtain the pigment, minerals containing malachite were selected for their green colour. Once selected, these would have been crushed and ground to a powder and then washed and processed. Another way to make the pigment is by natural precipitation. This happens in the waters flowing from the copper mines in the Carpathian Mountains. Wooden trays are placed on the mountainside to collect the precipitated material, and this is collected once a year and sold throughout Europe. When the pigment's made in this way, the particles are round, and it's these round particles that we can see in our painting. The coarseness of the pigment can influence both the handling and the colour properties of the paint. Finely ground malachite is too pale in colour for practical use, so the coarser, greener particles are preferred. However, the more coarse particles are much more difficult to work in a paint and difficult to apply in layers, so a compromise must be found. In our painting, the malachite particles are relatively large in size. This means that Bellini would have had to have used a relatively large amount of binder to create a workable paint. This binder reacts with copper and is discoloured. So although the pigment particles are still green in colour, St. James's cloak is now brown, and the modelling is barely visible. If you're interested in learning more about our collection, click here or here.
Thanks very much, and we'll see you next time.